what you have learned during the previous days and how you are going to be assessed, that will be discussed. Can anybody brief what you have learned from these 2 weeks lectures? Anyone? Can you hear me? And Kinza, can you hear me?
Assalamu alaikum, yes, sir.
Okay. Everybody should switch on their mics. Amjad, Ikra, Shanze, and it is a just discussion. And we'll go through some brief outline what we have learned, and I'll just talk about a few words about your assessment. Still, all have not joined, but we'll start it. The assignments which you were given, it was just a test for you that how you can write up something, how you can project something, because during this period you will be required to submit such type of the assignments regarding the medical laboratory technology and their different aspects. First of all have done a good effort. Few have done marvelous assignments and rest are the good one, but my opinion is that you should be able to write up such type of the assignments with the full command and full clear concept of the mind. I am happy that some have written very good because they are clear what they want to do in life. That is very important. Moreover, the concept of the assignment was to assess your writing capabilities, which will be helpful in future when you are going to write up the research paper or you are going to write up the SEQ also, attempt the SEQ. Sometimes your capability of writing in the exam speed is not enough to cope with the number of the questions. Sometimes the questions are lengthy and you have to answer them. Although there are of 5 marks each, but you have to be very to the point. But you must be able to get up the basic concept of that. I have gone through all the assignments. They are very good. At least some are motivated by having some inspiration. And I have seen all the assignments. I have documented the marks also with me that I will share you individually, not on the this Zoom meeting. Till now, I think you have gone through some different topics of hematology and histopathology, and the concerned teachers have taught you. And what is your opinion? Either you are satisfied with the way of the teaching, although I am not satisfied, because until and unless you do the practical, you will not be able to get the hold of the subject. I take the example of WBC count. I just tell you that counting of the white blood cell, they have many different methods, the old one and the new one. The issue is that either what we are counting is accurate or inaccurate, because we have to issue the report. Secondly, you must have in your mind not only the current methods, but you must have in mind the previous method for which there were drawbacks. You go through the question papers of the university and you will see that you will be given some scenario based questions, and mostly they will be like WBC count of some patient is 15,000 and the last report was of 7,000. What can be the problem with the report? I'm just giving you the example. So it may be asked that write up the different names of the methods by which we can count. First of all, you must be able to know what is WBC count, for what it is done. Importance of the WBC count, that is clinical, but you must know what are the causes of raised TLC or total leukocyte count, or what are the causes of the decreased WBC count, because that will help you in reporting in when you are in the practical field. If you have the causes in your mind, you may be able to report it confidently by taking the history if you are working in a hospital, and by taking the history from the patient if he is in the OPD. It's not only limited that you have done only the test, because as medical technologist, it is your obligation, it is your duty to deliver or issue the report properly and accurately. It should be precise and accurate. Accuracy and the precision you will learn in quality control later on. Your teachers, concerned teachers, must have told you many things about the WBC count or the hemoglobin. If I talk about the hemoglobin estimation, what are the different methods? Now, there are three components of your assessment for which you have to prepare the each topic. One is that MCQ. In MCQ, there will be a scenario that will be difficult to attempt sometimes because it is related with the patient. That at this stage, you may not be able to attempt that one. But after going through all the lectures, you will be able to, or going through the practical work in the labs, running labs, you will be able to catch up all these things. Second is your SCQ. That is very simple. If you have grasped the subject and the basic knowledge of the subject, that will be easy for you. I am happy that your writing capacity or the writing capability in English is good. it's not bad, because that is a prerequisite for a medical technologist to be on top. We are facing nowadays a lot of problems to hire the medical technologist because we don't find anyone. We interview, there is a problem for different medical technologists. They are unable to reproduce the 4 years course or 4 years work or internship. It means that whenever you are, may God help us that we get rid of this pandemic and we will be doing the practical work that will be helpful for you. The third is the VIVA. That will also is very important, that is to the point questions. Supposingly you are asked, what is the method for the determination of WBC count? Okay, fine, you will answer it, that will go through the hematology analyzer, or we may get it done with the routine Newbar's chambers method. But next question immediately will be, what type of the errors you can get out of this count, or you can face the difference in the count, and difference in the count by the manual will be definitely variable if you are not taking the right method or right method of counting or right solution. And what can be the problem with the solution? What can be the problem with the pipette? What can be the problem with the dilution? What can be the problem with the counting of that one? And what can be the problem in the hematology analyzer? Why it is not giving the accurate count? You may be asked, what are the factors for the erroneous count in WBC, or erroneous estimation or wrong estimation of the hemoglobin level, which is very important for assessment of the anemia. So first of all, if we consider the hemoglobin, you must know what it is made of. how it is measured, what is the significance of the hemoglobin, why we measure. If I ask some medical technology question, why we measure the hemoglobin, if he doesn't have the answer, you must answer it to assess the level of the hemoglobin in the body for classification of the, or for the documentation of the anemia. So this type of, your answer should be very precise and to the point. If you say that we are going to assess it for the anemia, the examiner will definitely be knowing that you have the basic concept. Then from that, the viva continues further. What type of the anemias can be? Then you are not going to give the clinical pictures, but you must know the basic things. What are the anemias, different types of iron deficiency or the megaloblastic anemia, whatever you are being taught, that I am not going to go into detail. The both subjects, they are very important in the future for your curriculum and for your syllabus and for your examination and for your practical work in the during the lab, and also when you work for the internship or you when you work for the in the proper lab as doing the job. So scenarios, problem solving scenarios, they are very important. I request all of you that you first go through all the question papers. If you get it from your colleagues, or you can get it from Mr. Takir, he can help you. You have to read the questions, what type of the SEQs are. Because one thing keep in mind, on 28th, next April, you will be having a full assessment what you have gone through till now. That will be about same pattern, which will be taken in the as per UHS pattern. So there will be questions, MCQ, which will be taken on the software, and then you will be given some SEQs that you have to write up. Then there may be, we may, because that will be the month of Ramadan, and we'll be having some sort of viva also individually, and that will be included in your assessment. Make sure that these assessments carry a weightage. This will be included in your internal assessment. So don't take it lightly. Don't take it so this is a normal exam, this is a normal monthly assessment. But monthly assessment, all these during the 7-8 months before your final prof, this will be counted and this will help you. If the assessment is good, that will help you in your taking the marks. If you are getting deficiency in MCQ attempt or SCQ, if you are getting the less marks, because I think there are 20 marks in both, 10 marks each in both, that is a huge number. If you are failing by 2 marks, that will be compensated by the assessment. So keep in mind, your assessment, monthly assessment, is very important. And whenever you feel difficulty in attempting the questions, that we can discuss, that is our responsibility. Moreover, first of all, Tuba, you tell me till now what difficulty you faced during this whole program. This type of the meeting, one meeting will be one Wednesday will be for the assessment, and one Wednesday of the month will be for the discussion. Here we can discuss all the things openly. What are the difficulties? How we can improve? How you can improve? What are the problems you are facing? Obviously, apart from your internet, apart from your online, but apart, you have to also give the opinion, give the feedback that we are facing problem with me, with teachers, with practical, whatever, because it's not going to harm you at any time, or it's not going to make you uncomfortable or thinking that you will be facing by some bullshit by the teachers. It's nothing to happen. This is a feedback forum, And it will be, because it's my responsibility to improve the teaching pattern and you solve the problems which you face during the teaching. So Tuba, you please tell what difficulties or what is type of, what is your experience with this sort of 2 weeks teaching?
Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Wa alaikum salam.
Sir, I have no problem with the teaching method, but there's a suggestion if you can work with that. Sir, jo hamare practicals hain, unki jo slides hain, मैं ये कहना चाहती हूँ कि वो जो स्लाइड्स हैं वो हमें प्लीज साथ हमारी शेयर कर दिया करें, जस्ट फॉर द प्रैक्टिकल्स. लेक्चर्स की बेशक ना भी हो लेकिन प्रैक्टिकल्स की हो जाए तो अच्छी बात है. क्योंकि वो प्रैक्टिकल हमने नोट डाउन करना होता है प्रैक्टिकल कॉपी में, तो इट विल बी बेटर अगर हमें प्रैक्टिकल की जो है वो स्लाइड्स मिल जाए.
ओके, व्हाट इज द क्वालिटी ऑफ द टीचिंग इन योर ओपिनियन?
टीचिंग सब टीचर्स बहुत अच्छा पढ़ा रहे हैं, कोई भी ऐसा नहीं है कि हम कहें कि नहीं उनका थोड़ा मेथड डिफरेंट है या वो हमें समझ नहीं आ रहा.
ठीक है, मैं एट दिस थैंक यू वेरी मच. आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट ऑल ऑफ यू दैट वन मस्ट बी बोल्ड इनफ टू गिव द ओपिनियन. दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू इम्प्रूव यू, टू इम्प्रूव अस. बिकॉज if the lecturing is and the practical, that is a very good suggestion which you have given, that the slides may be shared. That will be given asked to all the teachers to share the slides, and we will definitely post in the group, or you can take it by individually by the through the email to from the teachers. That will be done, that is not an issue. Secondly, Shanze, if I am pronouncing you rightly, Shanze Mariam. Shanze, are you? Andy, what is your opinion about these 2 week lecturing and discussion on the lectures and the practicals?
Sir, in 2 weeks में तो काफी अच्छा जा रहा है और अभी तक कोई problem नहीं हुई.
Suggestion?
Sir, no any suggestion.
Okay. build up your confidence in speaking, build up your confidence in giving the opinion, build up your confidence in being critical. There is no problem in that. That will enhance your skill also, because this MLT syllabus in later stages, okay, aap logon ko, it will help you to be critical. Regarding the reports also, you have to be very critical. If you have seen the reports, I will show you sometime, that report has to be seen critically. So you must be confident and not hesitant in giving opinion. Lareb.
Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikum salam.
उनका बहुत माशाल्लाह अच्छा है, उनसे नहीं है प्रॉब्लम. लेकिन सर जैसे तुबा ने कहा कि हमें थोड़ी जो प्रैक्टिकल का है हमें मसला, सिर्फ उसका जा रहा है सर, क्योंकि अभी वाइवा भी हमारा होगा और प्रैक्टिकल भी होगा, तो मैम सोचा उसमें थोड़ा सा मसला है, बाकी अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह बाकी ठीक.
चलो ठीक है
सर, अगर अगर हो सके तो सर आप लोग हमें खोल के हमें सिर्फ वो प्रैक्टिकल और वाइवे के लिए हमें वो अगर वो नहीं खोलते 19 को तो सर कुछ ऐसा हो सकता है कि आप हमें बुलवा के हमें वाइवे की तैयारी हम लोग कर सके साथ प्रैक्टिकल की भी, क्योंकि सर अभी
अगर 19 को क्लासेस स्टार्ट नहीं होती है तो अगर हमारी सिर्फ प्रैक्टिकल्स की क्लास
वाइवे की सिर्फ क्लास को किया जाए ताकि तक सर हमारी वो बन जाए ताकि हमें पास आते कैसे हैं.
ओके, फॉर दैट वी'ल डू द प्रैक्टिस इन द इन माय लेक्चर ऑफ द वाइवास दैट आई विल मेक यू हाउ टू present yourself, how to answer the questions. Moreover, the exact viva or according regard with the reference to the subjects taught, that will be at when your MCQ or SCQ will be complete. But one thing you must keep in mind that if you are feeling any difficulty in grasping the subject depth, or you are feeling problem in not understanding the methodology, not understanding the basic concepts, you can directly message to the teacher or me. Okay, number one. Number two, regarding the vivas, that I will post myself the different questions, what type of the questions can be in the viva, because our responsibility is to prepare you for everything. And moreover, your responsibility is to read and study properly this subject. I hope that all teachers have told you what which book you are going to read, and you stick that one. Don't get to the notes. Try to read the books, because this is the time. You have ample time. What type of, I'm giving you the example of hemoglobin, or if I give you the ESR example, if you have done the practical, if you have done gone through, what is the basic principle of ESR? This is the question. And here you must be able to answer what ESR, it is the sedimentation. Why there is sedimentation? What factors make them sediment? That you have to study. Which proteins help in sedimentation? What is the different methods of what type of the problems you can see? What are the causes of the raised ESR? What are the causes of decreased ESR? Although they're very less, but raised, they have many. So these type of the questions related to, you will not be asked with reference to some, what is the significance of the ESR in systemic lupus erythematosus. Although it is raised, this is a simple question. It can be asked later on. But relatively, with reference to the clinical scenarios, you are not supposed to answer them. Because last time I was, yesterday I was in UHS for some observation in MPhil MLT. The questions were clinical, so they had to be cut down. So it's not that you will be asked the questions which are beyond your syllabus, beyond your level. Apart from the treatment, the rest of the things you are supposed to know. If I take the example of hemoglobin that I gave, or if I take the count of the RBC count, what is the RBC count? If you don't know the normal RBC count, you will not never be considered a medical technologist. If you don't know in which units it is reported, you will not be considered, you will not be appreciated as a good medical technologist in during when you are going appearing for some job. If you don't know what type of the problems can be seen when we are measuring RBC count, that is very important. So similarly, I am giving on the examples of hematology. In histopathology, you may be asked, what is the procedure for the HND? What is the composition of the hematoxylin? How it is prepared? How gemcitabine is prepared? Because technicians level, they don't study. The medical, the difference between the pathologist and the medical technologist is very limited, in the sense that they deal with the clinical interpretation of the report. They deal with all the different types of the errors. They deal with all the different types of the methods. But you are doing all the things, starting from the sample taking, starting from the estimation, starting from the reporting, starting from the abnormal values, and reporting of the results with confidence. And in some places, medical technologists, when they become the section in charge, they have to be answerable for that one. What is the clinical condition? That is a separate thing. Why it is wrong? That is your domain. why it is not measured properly, what fault, when you are doing the benchwork, you will be able to know the fault. When the report is in front of you of 17 hemoglobin, you must know why it is. If it is 18 or 19, why it is there? Is there some error in measuring, or actually it can be some, of some condition? That's why I asked you that you must know some basic causes of clinical causes, basic, but not the whole disease. You are not supposed to, the pathogenesis of the disease is not required from you as per your syllabus. Seher Tariq?
Ji, sir.
Hello?
Andy, what is your opinion, brother?
सर अभी तक तो कोई मुश्किल नहीं आ रही, लेकिन सिर्फ प्रैक्टिकल में आती है, तो वो भी कुछ देर में ठीक हो जाएगा इंशाल्लाह।
इंशाल्लाह प्रैक्टिकल की बेटे देखो, ऑलवेज देयर इज अ प्रॉब्लम इन दिस ऑनलाइन टीचिंग, दैट इज द ड्रॉबैक ऑफ ऑनलाइन टीचिंग, दैट्स व्हाई व्हेनेवर इट इज अलाउड यू विल बी हैविंग गो मोर इंटरेस्ट इन दैट द सब्जेक्ट, इट्स वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग सब्जेक्ट एंड यू आर द बेसिकली द बैकबोन ऑफ द पैथोलॉजिस्ट ऑफ द लेबोरेटरी. Moreover, secondly, your MCQ, your assessment pattern, you will be given MCQs in the software in the when it will be on 28th April. You will be given SCQs, what you have of both subjects, the lectures you have gone through. So you then at that time, you will not be able to say that we have not studied this. Although practical aspect will be deficient to some extent, but the theoretical there will be no compromise, and try to be very critical in solving the questions. They may be scenario based, two or three lines MCQ you have to attempt. Definitely you have done it in the last prof, so it will not be difficult for you, but here it will be little bit scenario based, and in scenario based questions there are always some clue points, two or three, which are the only triggering point for your mind to work and to focus on that one. We'll take the MCQ on software. You will be given the assignments or SCQ, and you will have to submit it separately. That will be checked and the marked, and then will arrange some viva on Zoom if it is not opened by the government. So any any more suggestion which you have and you want to give, any difficulty?
No sir, abhi tak to nahi.
Anyone else?
Aage hogi to main bata dunga.
Okay, share it.
No sir.
सर
जी,
आई वांट टू से समथिंग सर, जो लेक्चर होता है हमारा वो प्लीज रिकॉर्ड करके फेसबुक वाले ग्रुप में शेयर कर दीजिएगा, मतलब टीचर्स वो उधर कर दे.
ठीक है, दैट आई विल आस्क ऑल द टीचर्स टू रिकॉर्ड द लेक्चर्स सो दैट इट कैन बी पोस्टेड इन दैट. Although it is just a beginning, we are also facing problem because of some other things due to the COVID. And all are busy, that will be done. I think 3, 3, 6, 8. Rest of the students are, I think I don't see them. So it will be marked, they will be marked absent, and your attendance is also very important. And one should not take it lightly, all the lectures, because when teachers come, they definitely get prepared and they do some effort. So we all must be present. Muhammad Ahmed, one. Who is this? Matur. I can't read his name. Who else is there?
Ahmed.
Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Wa alaikum assalam. Yes, please.
Sir, I don't have any suggestion, and everything is going very smoothly. And it was just about the practicals, and I have the same problem regarding the practicals that it's not enough for us to just take home classes and to do our practicals. And I mean, there must be some classes or physical classes.
That is okay, I agree, but that is not within our control. Until and unless government allows, we cannot go for that. Although these classes are less, but I suggest you that when the circumstances are not fair enough, then you own oneself has to work more at their own level. So my request is that if some difficulty is there, you try to solve it at yourself. Regarding the practical or anything, you get the material, you ask the teacher, you ask me, you can ask me. And if we, even then, when the classes are off, then one-to-one physical interaction, like direct, that will be definitely more helping and more promising for you to improve yourself. But you have with you the books. If one topic is taught, go through it. Just try to go through it so that you can get, you are not requested to memorize or rectify or everything. You have to just get to the basic concept of that. As I told you about ESR, as I told you WBC count, as I told you HND stain, for what it is stain. So you must be able to know it. So I request you that you get yourself motivated to read at your own, so that you must be able to speak it out. Develop the confidence of speaking. Develop the confidence of being critical. Positive criticism, not the negative criticism. So always go for the positive feedback. And if there is some problem in you, if you are not coping with, discuss with the teacher. Or you can discuss individually with me or with the teacher or with your coordinator. If there is some problem that I am unable to understand, I am not coping. Every student is not of the same level. But I think after doing this thing, you can write me directly the that I have noted down your suggestions and the reservations that we'll try to sort it out. Anything else, please? Because this time period is of 40 minutes only, we cannot go beyond that. I'll try that this lecture goes for 1 hour. But in next lectures, whenever we do it, try to be interactive during the lecture. If the teacher asks you, that you can check him or check her during while she's speaking, you want to ask the question, you raise your hand and then you do it. If teacher says no, questions will be at the end, then you can write up your questions and ask the teachers later, and or teacher can ask you individually or in the group. Okay, thank you very much. Anything else?
Sir, bas jo slide wala tha wo kar dijiyega, kyunki jo sabse basic ho na to wahi hum likh sakte hain practical mein. Agar kuch aise likh denge to fir
theek hai. But practical ke bare mein ek cheez mere zehen mein rakh le. If you are you have been taught regarding counting of the WBC, you please go to the YouTube, because I can at this moment I can say this go through that video, see it, and then you will be able to question the teacher also very easily. There are a lot of videos available for the teaching purposes. You can sign in them and you can get from different forums. If the slides which are taught to you by teachers, they will be shared by you, that I assure you. Okay, thank you very much. Attendance is most important in all the lectures that is being taken. So if anything you feel, you can write up and in the message in the group or individually to me, so that we can improve it. We have to make you so confident, more comprehend to comprehend more, and moreover, you must be bold enough to criticize the analysis of the methodologies and different parameters. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.